Boy good. Boy good. I mean, I've been harsh on Lukaku. This guy has been indoctored. I called him Tim's. I said he's useless. He moves like he's got two flipping anvils on his feet. Bro, this guy's G-ing up. And this guy's G-ing up. He's not only just scoring a few goals, he's really scoring goals. And I just think that for a lot of haters, and there are many haters out there who have insulted him, just not just me, you've got to step back and be like, you know what? Congrats to Conte, because Conte, bro, this guy's a magician. Diego Costa, give Conte a call. He's been working magic, but most credit has to go to Lukaku. That he's reminding people that, no, I am still that dude. And I'm still a top, top flipping striker. Because like, for me, I was already calling for like, oh, no, Origi should be a starter for Belgium and everything. But Lukaku's like, nah, chill. Let's just relax here. Shout out to, I think her name is Mina Rizuka something. Mina Ruka, whatever her name is. Like this female football analyst who said years ago that, you know, Morata is a far more intelligent and striker, that, you know, he's just much more smart, he's got a better footballing brain and just much more intelligence than Lukaku. Morata is missing open goals. We have a bed for him in Class A of the Brick Academy. Lukaku is G-ing up, okay? Dark skin is moving through. But look, man, Napoli is a different case here. I think, you know, when Sarri left, I thought it was going to be a decline. Then they managed to get Ancelotti. It was all cool. Then for some strange, inexplicable reason, De Laurentiis fell out with Ancelotti, player mutiny and so forth. It's all a flipping mess. And even looking at this game as well, there was no Koulibaly in the defense. You could see that the defensive leadership of Koulibaly, Inter Milan were really having their way in that defense, especially when they were attacking. So Napoli under Gattuso. Gattuso is an alright coach. I felt that he had a bad rap for AC Milan because he works with bricks. Where the hell are AC Milan now? What they are drawing with flipping Sampdoria, who are in the relegation zone. But I am. Do you know what really makes me happy about Inter Milan? Those two, man. How long have I been saying that? Bring back strike partnerships. Why does every single team have to play this dumb man? Okay. I wouldn't say dumb man. Why does every team have to play? Oh, 4-3-3, 4-3-1, 4-3-1, 4-3-3. Inside forward. False line. Decoy striker. These guys are. Because when I was growing up playing football, we had strike partnerships. We worked with a striker. You developed a partnership with a striker. And I think what Lautaro Martinez and Lukaku are doing are just reminding people that, man, there is a beauty in having two strikes. And I just think that it makes for better football matches and much more interesting football matches if you have two strikers with regards to the lone striker who's just there to pretty much breastfeed the inside forwards. But so it's just a great thing to see. And the amazing thing is that we have a title race. We genuinely have a title race. And I think that, you know, I'm still putting my money in Juventus. But it's fascinating, you know, for a league table, you know, that's always been a one-team league for so long. 8 consecutive times in a row, Juve have won the league. It is good that Inter Milan are at least trying to say what's up. And it's a very functional team that's happening. Huge for Senti to come back. And him coming back, you're not seeing just how good this flipping dude is. I mean, the defense is sexy, screening, doing his thing. So Conte, and it's amazing what Conte does in such a short space of time. He did it for Juventus, he did it for Italy, he did it for Chelsea. In a short space of time, he's able to have a massive, massive impact on a team. And it's already having a massive, massive impact on this Inter team. But really, man, Lukaku, man, that first goal that Lukaku scored. I mean, like, bro. Like, that's just outstanding. With regards to balance, technique, dribbling, focus, concentration, execution, and finishing, clipping off the post. I mean, what more can be said? That is just superb. And I just think that we will have to maybe revise. He deserved the abuse because he was playing like a brick. But as far as this season goes, I think we're going to have to revise and say, you know what? Lukaku might have to be tier 2. Lukaku, and that's a shock because I never knew. So based on what this guy was, I had a Class B brick. I never knew that he would ever be here. But I think we have to now put homeboy on tier 2. Upper tier 2, I think we have to now put him in tier 2 because that's what he's been doing right now. Remember to subscribe. Remember to like that vid. I'm out. Peace out. It's your boy HH.